Hello students, welcome back to the online classes. Today we are going to learn a new chapter. The name of the chapter is Fagin and his boys. Okay, so I will read the chapter once, then I will give you the explanation of the chapter. You can also open lesson 9 on page 57. Oliver Twist is the first major novel written by Charles Dickens. The novel Oliver Twist tells the story of a boy who had to suffer a lot of trouble. So here, the Oliver Twist is the major novel written by Charles Dickens. It's the story of Charles Dickens. Which is the story? Oliver Twist. And the novel Oliver Twist tells us the story of a boy who had to suffer a lot of troubles. In this story, we see about whom? About a boy who had to suffer in his life a lot of troubles. Okay? And Oliver Twist was an orphan. What is the meaning of orphan? One who has lost his parents, okay, mother and father, and living alone, orphan, okay. His mother died soon after his birth. So we see whose mother died? Oliver, the particular boy we see in the chapter. His mother died soon after his birth. And he lived in the workhouse owned by the parish. Parish means the church. So he was living in an orphanage run by the parish, okay, the church. He was treated very badly and was not given enough food. There he was, in fact, he was treated very badly and he could not get enough food there. One day, Oliver ran out of the place. The following lesson, the chapter from the novel, it talks about Oliver's journey after he had run away. So, from that particular orphanage, who is running away? Oliver is running away from that particular orphanage. In fact, he did not like that particular place or whatever it is. We don't know the reason, and maybe he had not got enough food there. And he ran away from that. And the following, the lessons, when we read it, it talks about Oliver's journey after he had run away. What happened after he had moved away from that particular place? You will see it in the chapter. Oliver walked more than 70 miles. He carried only a shirt, 2 pairs of stockings and a single penny. So, Oliver walked how many miles? 70 miles he walked and walked. Okay, in fact, he was tired and he carried only a shirt, 2 pairs of stockings, socks. How many pairs of? Only 2 pairs of stockings and a single penny, and he had a very little money. He was on his way to London. Where he was moving? He was going to London. No one, not even Mr. Bubble of the parish would ever find him in that big city. Here it says that not even a single person, even the in charge of that orphanage could not find out Oliver. Okay, because that city was very big and also could not find in that big city. It was cold and his feet were sore. Sore means hurt or pain. So when we are also in the month of November, December, and all, it's also very cold. We wear the soaps and wear the warm clothes to protect ourselves from the cold. So here also in London also is a very cold place, and there they have to wear the warm clothes and sore stockings. And also here, in fact, he did not wear a proper dress. So his feet were hurt because of the cold and were paining. But he was thrilled to leave his old unhappy life behind. But whatever it is, he was so happy to leave behind the unhappy life which he was living in the orphanage. So he moved away from that particular place without the knowledge of anybody there. Okay? He begged at cottages for food and water and slept in the haystacks in the meadows. So how did he had the food? Did he carry anything? No, he did not carry anything. He didn't have enough money to buy the food and to eat. So he begged. Cottage means the small houses that near the streets. He begged the from the cottages, from the houses, and also he slept in the meadow nearby the roadside. He slept. On the seventh day of his journey, Oliver met a boy who looked about his own age, but who dressed and acted like a man. So he was moving to where? London. And how many days he moved? 7 days. Such a long distance. 7 days. And on the seventh day, whom did he meet? He met a boy and looked about his own age, but who dressed and acted like a man. He was behaving like a grown-up man. Okay? He was short and bow-legged and had an ugly little eye. What was the structure of that particular boy? He was very ugly looking, and he was very short and bow-legged, and he wore dirty clothes and a hat that looked about ready to fall off his head. You can see it in the picture on page number 57. His picture is given, how he looked. Okay, the cat which was about to fall, and he was wearing a pants were baggy. Baggy means loose, so loose. And his coat reached down well below his knees. He did not have a proper dress, and such a funny he was looking. So his coat, his pants, his shoes, the hat which he was wearing, everything looked, it seems that a very funny man, isn't it? Okay, he, young fella, he greeted Oliver. He doesn't know the proper English also. So here it is written, he, young fella. Fella means here the meaning is fellow. He, young fellow, hello young fellow. He greeted Oliver. What are ya up to? What are ya means here, it is a you here. Ya here, the meaning is ya is you. Okay? So here it says that the boy greeted Oliver. Hello, little man, where are you going? I am tired and hungry. I have been on the road for 7 days, said Oliver to the particular boy. Oliver told that, I am so tired. I have been traveling since 7 days. I am on the road and I had not even taken anything. So I am feeling so tired. I feel weak and so hungry. Well, come on. I'll get you some food. Okay, you come on with me and I can give you some food. Jack Dawkins, better known as the Artful Dodger, brought some jam and bread and then took Oliver to a tavern. Tavern means here, it is written in the word power, places where we can take lodging or boarding. Places where we can take a lodging or boarding. So he took away, the particular boy had taken Oliver to a lodge, and he gave some jam and bread. Okay? It was the biggest meal Oliver had ever seen. It was the, so in fact Oliver was so happy. He had never seen such a big meal. So he was so happy and he thanked that particular boy. Going to London? Asked Dodger. Yes, said Oliver. So Oliver told the Dodger, the other boy's name. What is the other boy's name? Dodger. So told that, are you going to London? He told, yes, I am going into London. Okay, students, that's all today. I have finished the first part of the story. Here we see two children. The first one is the Oliver, who was moving away from the orphanage and going to London. And on the way to London, he met the boy. What is his name? Dodger. And Dodger gave him a jam and a bread and something to eat. And they are going on talking. They are on the way to London. Both of them are going. Okay. So, and also you will be reading the word meanings from the textbook and writing it in the copy and learning the word meaning and read the chapter properly and understand it. Okay, children. Thank you for listening.